Texas Victor Ortiz is a fighter many people consider the next superstar in the sport of boxing. And now he's about to face Marcos Maidana in a fight that's going to determine who will be the next WBA interim super lightweight champion.
What's up, Victor? What's going on?
What's up, dog?
Vicious Victor Ortiz is about to tangle with Marcos Maidana of Santa Fe, Argentina, and a boxer who's 25-1, including 24 knockouts.
We just said all the facts, man. He's a tough fighter. He's a hard puncher. I mean, what more can you expect, you know? Just the condition and the studying on the tapes is going to have to, you know, take over. And, of course, I'm not going to settle for any less.
Bueno, es la primera vez que vengo acá a pelear.
I'm in great condition and I'm very happy to be here first time in the United States, especially in Los Angeles. And I know that I'm going to make a great, great fight because I got a good condition and I know my opponent is a good opponent. And I'm pretty sure the people and watching the fight, they're going to enjoy that fight.
Victor has an impressive record of 24 wins, including 19 knockouts, and many people consider him as the next Oscar De La Hoya.
The most promising young fighter today, not just here in California, but frankly the world.
This young man has started a firestorm in the world of boxing. He is currently holds the NABO and the USBA belt.
He's going to be one of the best. Yeah.
Victor, how does it feel to be the next Oscar? Everybody's saying you're the next
superstar. I'm not Oscar De La Hoya, I'm Victor Ortiz. So, you know, that's it. He's nice though. I love him. But I'm just Victor.
One of the reasons Victor is such an inspiration to many is the fact that he's overcome so many challenges to achieve his success.
You have a young man who at the tender age of 13 years old was in foster care. At the tender age of 10 years old, had to work in fields in order to get food to feed himself. A young man who has been living and taking on the responsibilities of an adult while he should have been out there playing with his friends as a young man.
Now, there are a lot of fighters which can be champions, world champions, because of their talent. But there are very, very few who really have the ability to become a superstar. It takes the charisma. It takes the great smile. It takes the dedication. It takes working with the community, with the underprivileged children. It is all of that together which ultimately will make one a superstar. And yes, he needs to know how to fight. And this man here on my right, he has all of these ingredients. No challenge is too big for him. And he truly is blessed with the gift he has in his fists and what he has in his heart. And it's an honor for me to introduce to you Victor, Vicious Victor Ortiz.
First off, first and foremost, I just want to thank God, you know, of course, Marcos Maidana, you know, Argentinian, great fighter, great champion. You can't take nothing from him, and of course, you can't take him light. Then again, I never take anyone light, so. He's in great condition, as am I. We're just going to have some fun, dance with the devil a little bit.
Your favorite moment with Victor Ortiz, what is it?
It hasn't happened yet. It hasn't happened yet. When we win the world championship with number one trainer here, Danny Garcia, we're all gonna cry like little boys.
Danny, what makes Victor so good?
All that dedication that he puts in the gym.
What will be your keys to beating him?
You'd like to know, huh? June 27th, tune to HBO, or come to the Staples and I'll tell you all about it in the ring.
Victor tells me this fight is something that every fighter dreams about, an opportunity to win a championship. And he's going to give his all. From the Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.